In this episode of Diary of a Puzzle Gamer, we look at Wyrmlings, if that's how you pronounce it, and Eggs by Anne Stokes. This is a puzzle that I bought in my friendly local book and puzzle store, and it is 1,000 pieces, and originally it was not for me. I bought it for one of my kids, Louisa, who is now 9, and yes, Louisa can totally do 1,000-piece puzzles. This one, Louisa was very excited about, and then we started working on it together, and it turned out that was not as enjoyable to Louisa as we believed, and so basically I acquired it, I finished it myself. The idea is, of course, that this looks like a fictional page, or a page from a fictional book about dragons, taking these baby dragons as if they really existed, and so it looks like a science book, giving you all of the stuff that you always wanted to know about baby dragons. So what you have is these super cute illustrations that Louisa loved solving. And then you have a lot of text that got Louisa super bored. And that's when I acquired the puzzle. So I simply finished it and we agreed that that was going to be in my collection. Now, a little thing. The colors on the box and the colors on the puzzle look different, but I have to put a disclaimer there. It may just be that maybe they kept the box in the window at the store, because it just looks like the colors on the box are a little faded, which is not much of a problem. My gosh, my box looks faded. It just, as I was solving it, the colors didn't match and they made it a little harder. The edges, the big text there, that was easy, no problem. And solving the dragons was a lot of fun, because indeed they are super cute and they are, it's a reasonable challenge, but there are still some traps. Some of these pieces, when you're solving them, they don't look as far apart as from each other as they look now. Even some of the bodies of the dragon, some of the eggs, of course, these two look very similar, and that one also when you're solving them, but it's not a big deal, there aren't so many. But some of the bodies of the dragons, it surprised me how much I had to move them from one dragon to the other, because I kept trying to add them to the wrong one. And then it comes to the text, which, frankly, I don't mind. I don't know that it's my most enjoyable part. There are puzzles that I did with a lot of text, say puzzles about tanks, puzzles about airplanes, and you may have seen my videos for those. As such, that was interesting. Here, well, it's all made up, so it's not that after I create these texts and I'm told what these dragons does, and the shape of the egg, and the size at 6 weeks. That's not that interesting to me, really. It's not like I'm learning, again, about the real world, or if it was something similar about, you know, Lord of the Rings, or about the Song of Ice and Fire, I'm learning something about their dragons. It's just made up, really. But it's not made up in a way that, to me, is super interesting, because it's not related to a fully developed story world. Now, and so what you're going to do after you solve the dragons, most likely, is you take a piece randomly, you read the you look at the text there, looking for where it goes, and you put it there. So a considerable part of the puzzle is about mechanically solving the text. And so that's kind of like the minus or pluses and minuses. So it's a puzzle that I enjoyed reasonably. I mean, I enjoyed it enough that I finished it. I'm stubborn. I finish almost every puzzle that I start. But I didn't mind finishing it. I wasn't particularly excited by the end. I was like, okay, done. It wasn't like super satisfying. It was somewhere average there. Average / below average. As for the quality, the fit is pretty good once the puzzle is solved. As I was solving it, the fit felt pretty loose, and moving pieces around or clusters of pieces around was not super easy, and they would keep falling apart. And so I wish that the fit was a little tighter. Although again, it looks perfectly fine now. Kind of surprising how sometimes the two things, as you solve it after you solved, may be quite different. And the pieces are thick enough. Again, not like fancy, but everything very reasonable. Production wise, it's a well made puzzle. So overall, it is well made. The design is good enough. Not my favorite design, just because a lot of text that again to me was not particularly interesting. But again, I finished it, so I liked it enough. This is my assessment for Wyrmlings and Eggs by Anne Stokes.